Let's get ready with today's flow for a good morning stretches to open up the body and start fresh in your day-to-day filled with positivity and enthusiasm. So let's start by rolling the shoulders back as you inhale up and exhale back. Keep going, just warming up the body. And inhale, bring your hands into Namaskara Mudra in front of your lower chest. And let's begin with a short prayer to connect ourselves by chanting Om three times. Inhale. Take a moment to center yourself. Inhale, raise the hands up above your head and exhale them down. Wide circle. Inhale up, exhale, wide circle. Open up your chest. Keep going at your own pace. Feeling the stretch in your chest. The opening. Wide circle, and then cross the arms to your shoulders, bend down and inhale, open up the chest. Exhale down, inhale, open. Down and open, ensure your feet are touching each other. Straight back when you bend down, keep going at your own pace. Open up the chest. Now interlock your hands above your head, raise the heels up. Balance yourself, feel the stretch, push your arms back, feel it, and exhale down. Release yourself, and again, come back up. We're going to do this a couple of times, and touch down, touch the floor if you can. Then inhale, come back up, interlock the hands above your head, feel the stretch, raise the heels up. And bend down, touch the floor. Inhale, up. Try to go even deeper now, your body is ready. And exhale down, touch the floor. Inhale, up. Raise the heels higher and exhale. Come down, interlock the hands behind your back and fold back into a back bend. Open up your chest, relax the shoulders. Try to go as deep as you can and then come back to center. Inhale, raise the hands up and twist to the side. Keep going, twisting from one side to the other side. Just warming up the spinal cord and then come back to center. Spread the feet apart slightly. Inhale, raise the hands up. Exhale, bend down and hold your big toes, straighten your back. If you want, you can raise one heel at a time if you're feeling like you're a little bit stiff. Check with your body. Breathe as deeply as you can. Breath is the heart of yoga. Breathe, go deeper, uttanasana. Nice, inhale, raise yourself up. Going into trikonasana. So ensuring that your heels are in one line. Inhale, raise the arms parallel to the floor and exhale, extend and drop down, right side. Open up your chest as much as you can. And then inhale your way up and glide to the other side. Trikonasana, triangle pose, extend, go down. Wherever you're comfortable, you can touch the floor or the ankles, whatever works for you. And then inhale up, interlock your hand above your head, Then make a wide circle with your entire body. This is called around the world. Wide circles. Keep going at your own pace. Feel the opening in your body. Really nice way to warm up. Keep your back straight when you go down if you can, and then switch the side of the rotation. Keep going. Then inhale, come back to center, release the arms and allow them to be behind your lower back. Open up into a baby back bend. And then exhale, Parshvottanasana to the right side. Try to touch the forehead to the knee. And then walk your way to the other side. And feel the stretch in your hamstrings. Then inhale, come back up as you're comfortable. And jump back, Samasthitihi. Lovely. Coming at the edge of your mat. Take a moment here. Allow the palms to face upwards to receive the higher energy. And then inhale, raise the hands up again above your head. Exhale, bend down. Step 4 feet in the front. With your hands, plank position. Hold, engage your core. Walk the hands back into Uttanasana. Inhale, raise the hands up again, interlock them, feel the stretch. Exhale, down. Gliding into your plank position, engage your core. Walk the hands back, nice and steady. Inhale, up. And exhale, keep going. Plank position. Hold here, coming back, nice and steady. Inhale, raise the hands up, feel the stretch. Lovely, you should really be feeling a deeper opening in your shoulders now. And exhale, release. High knees, without the jump if you're not comfortable. And if you're comfortable, you can surely try to add a jump, depending on what you want. So keep going, either the variation without the jump or the jump. Beautiful. Now let's glide into lunges, allowing the back knee to bend, almost touching the floor. Keep going, hands are above the head. And then when you're comfortable, switch the side. Keep going at your own pace. Today's practice is at your own pace. You should feel comfortable. So just keep going as much as you can do. Then come back. Interlock the hands again behind your back and see this time, can I go deeper into my back bend? Can I open up my chest even more? And then come back to center. Inhale, raise your hands up. Exhale, fold forward, keeping the back straight, and step back into Adho Mukha Svanasana. Activate your entire body, from your fingers to your toes, everything. Push the shoulders in. Downward facing dog. Now gliding, inhale, upward facing dog. Urdhva Mukha Svanasana. Relax the shoulders. Downward facing dog, nice and steady. Upward facing dog. Downward facing dog. Urdhva Mukha Svanasana. Inhale. And then exhale yourself down into Balasana. Spread the knees apart, take a lot of distance, and just relax, allow your hips to melt, and just relax, breathe. And then when you're comfortable, inhale your way up onto your knees. adjust yourself, place your hands behind your back, lower back, and let's glide into baby Ustrasana. Open up your chest, see if you can go deep. Breathe as deeply as you can. Don't forget to breathe. And then very gently come back to center. We're going to twist from side to side just to release the spine after such a back bend. Beautiful. Just go from side to side at your own pace. Be comfortable. Level 2. Hands behind the back thighs and go into Ustrasana. Open up further. Now your body is ready. If this is too difficult, stick to step 1. There's no problem. It's your journey. Keep breathing. Inhale. Come back to center and one more time, twist, release the whole spinal cord. Now let's try the final variation, Ustrasana, once we're comfortable. Prepare yourself. Inhale, raise the hands up, nice and energized. And then exhale, place your hands on your heels. Open up the chest. Beautiful. And let's stay here, keep breathing. If you need to stay to step 1 or 2, that's completely fine. Check with yourself. Then come back to center, inhale. Now twist from side to side to release the back with your hands interlocked above your head. And then release the arms. Coming into Vajrasana. And take a moment here to yourself. Palms facing upwards to receive the higher energy. Yoga is a practice not just of movement of the body, but also checking your mind. So just take that moment. And then interlock your hands behind the back, inhale up. Exhale, surrender yourself and bend down. Inhale, open up the chest. Exhale down, this is the moon breathing. Keep going at your own pace. Allowing yourself to be with the breath as you inhale, raising the chest up. And exhale, bending down. Nice and steady. Feeling yourself getting refreshed with every breath. And then coming into a beautiful tabletop position. Cat and cow. Pitil asana, mercury asana. Curve your back, look up. Round your back, looking at your belly. Beautiful. Keep going at your own pace. This will really help to massage the entire back. So really try to round it beautifully and curve it as much as you can. And then come back to center. Lift your right hand up and left leg up. Balancing tabletop. Engage your core. Look ahead of you. Perfect. Now let's try to touch the ankle with the hand and twist to the side. Beautiful morning stretch. Look up if you can. Perfect. And release. Let's do the same sequence on the other side. So opposite hand to foot. Balancing tabletop. Engage your core. You can do it. And then gliding into our twist. Perfect. Breathe. Don't forget to breathe. And then release the leg. Coming back into Balasana. Wide-legged Balasana. Open up your knees. Feel the stretch in your hips. And breathe. Nice and steady. And then make your way up again and relax in Virasana. You'll feel a nicer stretch now in your thighs. And take a moment here to yourself one more time. It's all about connecting to yourself before we go into our days. And then if you're comfortable, glide your elbows down and see. Able to feel a deeper stretch now in your thighs. And if you're comfortable and you're really fine, then completely drop down. Allow your back to touch the floor and relax. For whoever has any knee problems, suggesting to do this entire flow in Baddha Konasana. And then when you're ready, come back up, nice and gentle. Relax in Vajrasana. Check how you're feeling. How is my state of mind? What am I feeling? And then allowing both the legs to come into Dandasana. Make yourself comfortable. And let's do some heel stretches here. Pointing the toe and flexing them. Feel the stretch in your feet. Nice and steady. Then hold and grab your right foot. Kronchasana. Allow the back to be straight, knees are also straight. Feel the stretch in your hamstrings. Bend the knee and straighten it. Couple of times here, just to get a deeper stretch. For whoever is a little bit stiff, this will help you. And then place the leg down and glide into Marichyasana, twist to the side. Hands in chin mudra, if you can. Feel the twist. Perfect. Release, and let's do the same sequence on the other side. Pranayama first to start off with. Make yourself comfortable. Let's stay here first. Couple of breaths, and then start bending the knee and straightening it. Just for a deeper stretch. Perfect. As much as you can, don't worry, your own comfort. We're just opening up. And then twist into Marichyasana. Release the leg. And then very gently make your way into Paschimottanasana. And see now, your body is ready. If you need to just raise one knee at a time, that's completely fine. If you're comfortable, you can also place your hands on the bottom of the feet, whatever you want. Just allow the hamstrings to open up further. Ensure that your back remains straight and look ahead of you. Nice and steady. And then release. Allow the elbows to allow you to know the measurement for Purvadvanasana, and inhale, raise yourself up. Half reverse tabletop. Engage your core, open up the shoulders. Fingers are pointing towards yourself. Perfect, and down. Release, inhale up. Come on, we can do it. Now you're gonna place the right leg on the left thigh. And see the difference. And then the other side. Left leg on the right thigh. And then come down very gently. Give yourself a little bit of a hug. Just relax. Allow your back to be straight. Roll yourself from side to side. And then as you're comfortable, make your way into Baddha Konasana, butterfly pose. Open up your hips furthermore. You can do it dynamically, whatever you're comfortable with. Feel the stretch in your hips. Breathe as deeply as you can. Keep breathing. Beautiful. Cross the legs and step back one more time into Ardha Mukha Svanasana. And now see, can I go deeper than the first time I did it? My body is ready. I can push further. Yes, I can. Go deeper. And then, gliding your right leg towards the front into pigeon pose. Nice back bend, relax the shoulders, feel the stretch in the hips. Breathe, don't forget to breathe. Energizing your entire body and mind today. And then exhale, let's do baby push-ups here. At your own pace. Folding the elbows. As much as you're comfortable. And then very gently allowing both the hands to come towards the front. Surrender completely. Breathe as deeply as you can. Forward fold pigeon. Now let's try something new today. Come back up. Breathe. Center yourself. Nice. Now we're going to go into the twisted pigeon. So twist your body towards the side and allow the hand to come above and touch your ear. And then inhale yourself up. Release. Then lift yourself into Adho Mukha Svanasana. Breathe for a couple of breaths here. See the difference in your body. And then let's do the same sequence on the other side. Left leg comes towards the front. Ek Bhadrajka Bodhasana variation. Nice back bend. Open up your chest. Feel the stretch in your hips. And then exhale. Down, inhale, up into your baby push-ups. Slow and steady as much as you can. Allow yourself to be comfortable. Sthiram Sukham Asanam, that's important. Stable and comfortable. And then release, surrender. Forward fold, just stay there and breathe. And gliding into our twist, twisted pigeon. Feeling a deeper stretch in the sides of your body. Breathe. And then inhale, make your way up again. See the difference in your body. And then exhale your way down into Adho Mukha Svanasana. Beautiful. Feet parallel to each other. Nice. Inhale. Urdhva. Coming onto your stomach. Perfect. Inhale, raise yourself in Bhujangasana now. And exhale down. Inhale, up. Exhale, down. Ensure that your elbows are folded in. Inhale, up. Exhale, down. Inhale up and exhale down. Inhale, exhale down. You'll feel a nice stretch in your lower back, and once you're comfortable, just relax in happy crocodile pose. You can move your feet front and back, side to side, whatever you want. Just enjoy it. Happy crocodile. Then once you're comfortable, grab both your ankles and raise yourself up into Dhanurasana. Rock yourself front and back if you can. Lift yourself as high as you can. And relax. Release your ankles. And glide one more time into Makarasana. Happy crocodile pose. Breathe. Center yourself. And then inhale and make your way into Balasana, wide-legged Balasana, just relax. Taking this moment to center yourself and ask yourself, how am I feeling? What am I feeling? Can I be aware of what I'm feeling? Beautiful. Inhale, lift yourself up. Sitting into Vajrasana. Moment of connection with yourself. And then exhale, make your way into a supine position. And raise your hands up above your head, interlock them. Point your toes as though you've just woken up in the morning. A nice stretch from head to toe. Beautiful. And then very gently, taking your right toe, straighten the leg into a variation of Supta Padangushtasana. You can let the other knee be bent. Feel the stretch. Breathe. And then coming into a supine pigeon pose, allowing the same leg to be on the left thigh. And give yourself a hug, feeling the stretch in your hips. Breathe. And release. Let's do the same sequence on the other side. Supta Padangushtasana variation, left leg. And then when you're comfortable, gliding into your supine pigeon. Giving yourself a baby hug here, feeling the stretch in your hips. Just relax. Release the legs, gliding into Anand Balasana, hold both your toe, side to side, front and back, happy baby pose. So just enjoy it, relax. Feel the hip opener here. And then get both the legs together, straighten them, Uttan Padasana, hold your big toes. Whoever needs to use a belt, you can. Breathe. Then very gently, Bhavan Muktasana. Point your toes, give yourself a hug, relax. Once you're comfortable, from here, make circles with your knees here. This is extremely beneficial to release any lower back pain. So making gentle movements here, circular movements with your knees. Hands on the knees. And then the other way around. Switch the rotation. Feel the opening in your back. And then gliding into Ek Pad Bhavan Muktasana, hugging your right knee in. Point your toe. Breathe, just relax. And then when you're comfortable, switch the side. Ek Pad Bhavan Muktasana, left side. Feel the stretch. And then let's do some arrow shooting movements. So opposite elbow to knee. Engage the core. At your own pace, keep going. And then relax, Bhavan Muktasana, touching the forehead to the knee, if you can, flexing the feet, release. And when you feel comfortable, glide yourself down into Supta Baddhakonasana. You can choose to either place your hands on your belly or to the side of your body, but then palms will face upwards to receive the higher energy. And just relax. Allow gravity to do its own work. Breathe as deeply as you can, feeling centered, calm, connected, and content. Just relax. And as you're comfortable, very gently, make your way into Shantarovarasana. Knees are folded, touching each other, a little bit of gap between both the feet. Really good for whoever has any back problem, this will be extremely comfortable. And allow a deeper sense of relaxation to occur. Just relax and focus on your breath. Taking in all of the prana, filling yourself with positivity. Just relax. For whoever has any back problems, stay where you are in Shantarovarasana. And whoever is okay, glide yourself down into Shavasana, extend your legs. And just relax. Complete relaxation. Letting go of whatever does not serve your highest good, any negativity, let it go. And inhale, fuel yourself with only positivity and love. So let go completely now, just let go. Very gently move and wiggle your fingers and your toes, coming back to body consciousness, and turn to your right side into Garbha Triptasana, baby in the womb pose, and spend a little bit of a moment with yourself here. We tend to be friends with the whole world, but what about being friends with ourselves? So just take this moment to yourself. To be with yourself. Once you're comfortable, inhale, raise yourself up into a comfortable seated position, either Vajrasana or Sukhasana, whatever is comfortable, or if you need to use a chair, that's completely fine as well. Ready for a short meditation that we will practice together. Closing your eyes, keeping your back, neck straight and in one line. Begin by taking deep conscious inhalations and exhalations. Awareness of every single breath that you take. As you inhale and exhale, allow every breath to make you more peaceful, connected, calm, and centered. So just focus on your breath. Deep inhalations. Deep exhalations. The mind may wander away in the past or the future. It's okay. Very gently, bring it back to the present moment by connecting to your breath. Awareness of your breath. Be aware of every single inhalation and exhalation, calming yourself completely, coming to a balanced state of being. Continue this process for some time. Now let us add a meaning to your breath. As you inhale, inhale positivity and love. As you exhale, let go and exhale negativity and anger. Inhale positivity and love. Exhale negativity and anger, let it go. Inhale, positivity and love, fuel yourself, refresh yourself. And exhale, negativity and anger. Continue this process for some time. With every breath, let yourself become lighter and lighter. Feel yourself being empowered, positive, letting go of any extra baggage that's holding you back. It's just not needed to keep it. Let it go. Just let it go with your exhalation. Continue to breathe in this manner, inhaling positivity and love, and exhaling negativity and anger. I am a peaceful and a powerful soul, just playing my role. I am a source of infinite bliss. I am not dependent on the external for my happiness. I generate my own happiness. I have a portable paradise. Nothing can affect me. I am powerful. I am an ocean of unconditional love, and I extend to to all those around me. I am a peaceful and a powerful, pure soul, simply playing my role. I am pure consciousness. I am bliss. I am love. I am. I simply am. Sahajatma Swarup Param Guru. Sahajatma Swarup Param Guru. Sahajatma Swarup Param Guru. Bask in this experience for some time. Very gently start taking deep conscious breaths, cleansing breaths, coming back to your environment. Become aware of every inhalation and exhalation, feeling that calmness and quietude, serenity within yourself. Allow yourself a couple of last moments here with yourself. As you set your intention for today's new day, why am I alive today? What is my purpose for today? What do I want from today? I'm grateful for this new day. With a strong intention to live another day, bring your hands together in pranam mudra. Rub your palms together, generate that energy. And And whenever you are comfortable looking at both your palms with the feeling of love and gratitude, open your eyes. Namaste.